trouble, baby. And I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. And I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Nobody really understands, no.
I'm trying to make it out my city, cause my city killer. Trips to Anguilla, far from jungles with gorillas. I gotta make it, but a simple fact, I'm not a quitter. Rest in peace to Terry Berry, one real nigga. Whole lot of niggas hate like racism, so I dive inside my own dreams for escapism. It's gotta be a better way, I need some better days. Instead of red tape with blood stains where bodies lay. I seen a nigga get arrested just yesterday. The streets are chess, not checkers, so we call the case. The streets is not a game, it ain't no replay. When bodies decay, then meet the pearly gates. I'ma make it to the top, so I keep the faith and keep away from snakes. Middle fingers to the jakes. If you starving, most niggas won't feed you food or give a helping hand, so you must believe in you.
And I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. And I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. And I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Nobody really understands, no.
Love homie malnourished, he ain't got dinner. And his mama shooting dope summer through the winter. That kind of shit'll make the little shorty so bitter. And he'll probably kill a nigga for a chicken tender. When the last time he ate, shit he can't remember. Landlord said the rent passed through since December. Same clothes the youngin' wearing like every week. And he don't want no night sneaks, man, he wanna eat. Coming up in the ghetto made his heart numb. Went from a 25 to a 9 with a drum. I know this chick, but she really need a brain, man. But it seems as if the girl won't change, man. With this nigga, that nigga, that nigga. Slim fat nigga, white nigga, black nigga. It don't even really matter, nigga. Planning out steps just to make her pockets fat.
It's bound to forsake me. And I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. And I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. And I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Nobody really understands.
I'm trying to make it out my city, cause my city killer. Trips to Anguilla, far from jungles with gorillas. I gotta make it, but a simple fact, I'm not a quitter. Rest in peace to Terry Berry, one real nigga. Whole lot of niggas hate like racism, so I dive inside my own dreams for escapism. It's gotta be a better way.
Listening to DISRACE coming to you live from the new improved Uptown Comedy Corner. DISRACE, Well, our motto has always been no hate.
No fear.
But no fear. You got to know when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away.
And we ain't doing no
we
running.
We do no running. Respect everybody.
Fear none.
And fear no damn body. I got my main man, the Muslim professional extraordinaire, ladies and gentlemen, old soft voice boy here.
Assalamu alaikum, my brothers.
Assalamu alaikum. One day when we had time, I'm going to get you to spell it.
Right, I was going to say the same thing.
I got you.
Can you spell it?
You going to spell it Islam?
You can spell Assalamu alaikum.
Of course I can.
In Islam or English?
You mean Arabic?
Arabic, I'm sorry.
I can do it in Arabic and English.
Oh, really? You're smart, huh?
Yeah. I mean, I'm not saying I'm smart. You know, a lot of people can do it.
But you don't.
Salaam. Salam. To my immediate right, I got our chaplain, for what it's worth, ladies and gentlemen. Was it claim to fame? He's Roman Harper's brother. Ladies and gentlemen, show your love for the Mohican minister himself. The one, the Reverend, the Right Reverend. They call him the Right Reverend.
That's right.
Right Reverend Brian Harper.
That's right, everybody. Always winning, never losing. Never losing.
He our chaplain. Now, what they got to do with the Lord?
Keep telling you, man. I'm glad you give me that platform every time to answer the question. Because as long as I got God, I ain't never losing. I'm glad you get that question up, man.
Now, when you say that, do you mean God or Jesus?
All one and the same. You know, Jesus is an extension of the Father, so all one and the same. So that as long as I got God, means I got
why
Jesus.
Why you think God sent his only begotten son instead of his only begotten daughter?
I ain't never read in scripture if he had a daughter.
Why you looking at me, DC?
I think one thing we can say is God bless is way easier to spell than Assalamu alaikum.
Jesus will.
Exactly. Brian probably can't spell neither one of them. To my far left, ladies and gentlemen, the black box, my co-host, the new improved sober Bo P.
Hootie who?
Bo.
Yes, sir.
You ain't fell out the way.
Nah, man.
It's almost what, 3 months now?
About four.
How you feel, man?
I feel good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Feel better?
Yeah, I feel good.
Yeah, appetite all right?
Yeah, appetite fine. Ding-a-ling fine. Everything good.
Oh, Lord.
Say,
you heard that? You heard that? About everything else?
I'm not interested in your ding-a-ling.
I know you ain't, but somebody out there is. How y'all doing?
This black box folks know everything. You don't know shit. To my immediate left, ladies and gentlemen, she's the eye candy of the group other than myself. But I have no cleavage.
Thank God for that.
Well, we.
She's a community activist. She's an actress extraordinaire. She's a movie producer. What was the last movie you did? It's on what you call it?
Amazon Prime.
Tubi 9.
Too crazy on another level.
Crazy on another level.
Too crazy.
And got another one now. What's the next one?
Men Pray Too.
Men Pray Too.
Ladies I like that one.
Show your love, Sister JJ.
I'm here. Thank you, DC. I love being here.
Then we got Weight Ball on the side. Weight Balls.
Weight Ball in the building. It's a pleasure.
Glad to have you, man. We know we miss you when you are not here. You weren't here last week.
I did call in sick.
Yeah, you called in. Yeah.
You know, I had a show. I really wasn't sick. But,
yeah.
And it was amazing, too, by the way, but that's a separate show.
Yeah. Yes.
He had a show. He wasn't here. But he called in sick, which would be more believable than he had a show. But anyway. No, he had a show. That's good, man.
Yeah, Weight Ball doing his
thing. Y'all wait till y'all see some of the guests we got tonight, boy. Y'all gonna be like, DC. Oh, Carla here.
Hey.
She ain't bring no sandwiches today.
Thank you.
No. She's slipping.
She ain't got her stamps yet.
You ain't gotta bring no sandwiches every time, Carla.
Bo P.
We sure appreciate it.
Yes, she
appreciate
does.
Appreciate it when they're here.
Yes, she does.
And, In our next, y'all gonna be surprised who here today, boy. I'm gonna shock y'all. I'm gonna shock y'all. Oh, hold up, Sister JJ, activist.
I thought I had it on silent.
That's him.
She did not tell him where he was. She was already late.
Well, we made it through another week. Reverend, God bless the brother that was locked up for 12 years. Mm. 12 years, and they finally found out or proved that he didn't do it. Jake Tapper's daddy.
Yep.
Does it ever
got him out? 12 years.
12 years. That's a long time.
He was sentenced to 60, but he got out in 12.
And what was he in for?
Killing a girl.
Supposedly. Yeah.
The white girl.
I think she was black.
Right. Well, either way, it's sad that
12 years of a man's life gone, man.
They got somebody on death row. Is he the one that was on death row?
No, he had 60 years.
They executing somebody today or tomorrow.
No, right now. In Atlanta. Matter of fact. Yeah.
Can I ask y'all like a question for this
Atlanta
panel?
First right here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What did he do? Who he kill?
He killed a black
killed
woman.
Killed his girlfriend.
His girlfriend?
Yeah.
You get death penalty for killing your girlfriend?
Yeah.
If you do it in front of the kids, yeah.
Can I ask this panel a question? Do you guys ever notice that nobody that, at least I can't recall, nobody Asian or white or anything like that gets wrongly accused and spend his time behind bars?
I ain't never heard of it.
I ain't never heard of it.
I'm not trying to pull like the race card, but I just never seen one. I've never seen an Asian dude that's done a crime and he's just wrongly accused and sat up for 18,
and they
20
all look,
years.
Yeah, and they
at
all
least
look
it's
alike.
Not as it's not as never it's seen not it. It's not as frequent.
I've
as
never heard
black
of, I've never
people.
Heard a white man wrongly accused.
I ain't never I'm gonna top that, man. Mm. I've never heard of a white man being convicted of raping a black woman.
Wow.
That's true. I've
never heard that.
No. You ever heard?
I never heard
I
that.
Asked my partner who's a judge, man, in Fulton County. And man, he sat back in his chair. He said, DZ, I ain't even. Hmm. Yeah, I ain't get back with him, but he said he was gonna have somebody research it. I never heard, and you know damn well that's happened.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I've never heard of a white man being convicted of raping
mm-hmm.
a black woman. Yeah, that's true.
I heard of some white men raping some black men getting that's going on in Mississippi right now. Some
and
white
he got
guys,
convicted.
They got him, yeah. Yeah, they raped some black men.
Where was the boy that did 12 years? Was that Mississippi? No, Mississippi is where the police had the little crew.
Yeah, they
was out.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, literally lynching the boy.
Yeah.
Yeah, they got
and
some
they
time
convicted.
Too.
One of them got 40 years.
Yeah, they got some time.
And two of them left.
One got 20. One got 17.
The goon squad.
I don't feel as though it should be a number. I don't feel as though they should have a number. It should just be life. It should be life. They shouldn't even have a number. 20 years, 17 years, 20, no, life, natural life.
So they just croak inside.
Exactly.
Okay. I guess you can't get a death penalty for nothing but murder, right? Is that right?
That's what I would think. I've never heard anybody
getting capital murder, too.
Yeah, I've heard anybody, never heard anybody getting a death penalty.
Somebody said Asians are model citizens.
Okay.
Who said that? Bruce Lee? Some Asian.
Wait, did the guy that shot Reagan, did he get the death penalty?
Hell no.
No.
Oh, okay.
He got out.
He out.
He out.
Yeah, he got out.
Dang. Okay. I didn't know. I wanted to make sure. That's why I asked the question.
White folks.
You don't get death penalty for shooting no president, which is why. I can't say that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we want to stay on. Don't say it, DC. We want to stay on.
Yeah, I feel bad for the brother, though. 12, 13 years. And he come out, man, just nice. Boy, if I did 12 years of something I didn't do, and they ever let me out.
You're going to start doing something.
You're going to do something.
I'll be the worst motherfucker. Boy.
Yeah. Just talk bad to people.
And then the brothers that were lynched literally by the police, the goon squad in Mississippi. So the boy gave old half-ass apology. One of them, fourth one convicted. And then, man, black folk, man.
He said, I forgive him.
Said, I forgive him. You remember the brother in Dallas, Botron John, and the white woman police officer killed him.
Right. And his brother.
And I swear they were dating, man.
Yeah. Yeah.
And his brother got on the stand after it was over and
said, I forgive you.
Asked the judge, can I give her a hug?
I'd slap shit out of him.
Yeah, man.
I'm sorry.
And I'm with you, DC. I think she was dating. There's no way she came in.
She was dating. She thought she was in her apartment.
She was dating.
On third floor. He on the first floor.
Yeah.
You kicking your own damn dope for.
Yeah, exactly. Then you see a figure, you just automatically got your gun
and
drawn.
And brother, so here's my question, man. As black people, are y'all too forgiving, really?
I think we are.
I mean, we're forgiving people. Walk around with a chip on your shoulder all the damn time.
But. We're forgiving people. We forgive white folks what they've done. You don't see us killing a bunch of white, going on a rampage and massacres, you know, for what they've done for us in the past.
I'm not suggesting you do that.
No, right. But I'm saying we are forgiving people by nature. Black people are.
Yeah.
Mm.
I just think that you can, if you want to forgive a person, that's fine, but you still got to pay the price. You know, because God is a forgiving God, but you still have to pay the price. So, you know, just because you're forgiven doesn't mean that you're excused.
Exactly.
Yeah, be like, I forgive you.
I ain't forgiven.
Now get your ass in penitent, huh?
Cross me, I ain't forgiving. Yeah. I'm not forgiving.
Well, you should still. And forgiveness is not for the person. It's really for yourself. So people get it mixed construed. It's not that I forgive you because I'm excusing what you did. No, I need some peace within myself. So I'm going to excuse the fact that you allowed that evil to overpower you to do this evil to me. However, it doesn't excuse your punishment.
You sound just like a common nigga.
What? First of all, ain't no nigga blood up in me.
I forgive you. This is for myself. No. I wish somebody would do something like that to me. I ain't forgiving him or his family and none of them crackers.
Again, forgiveness is for the person.
I forgive.
And some people, if they don't forgive, then it eats them up. So they have to forgive. But it doesn't excuse the fact that the person still needs to be chastised for what they did.
So you don't hold no grudge against nobody, JJ?
What's that?
That's what I thought.
You don't hold no grudge against nobody.
I'm not mad.
She's taking that sip again.
I'm not mad at nobody.
Whenever she take that sip of that ginger ale, buddy, you gotta get a sip of
baby daddy. Four
baby daddies. We all good. I might not rock with everybody, but I ain't mad at nobody.
You ain't mad at nobody.
I ain't mad at nobody.
Well, that's good, because that means you realize that at least in some of the cases, it was you. You were the problem.
Now, with the baby daddies, it was not me, but I'm not always right.
I knew you were going to get a change that one.
Remember John Malcolm, the one who, him and the boy was in D.C. shooting people?
Mm. Yeah, of course.
Did any of the white folk forgive him?
No. Some things you got to forgive now. You can't. I mean, you might not forgive and forget. I ain't with that. But some things you got to forget. You can't be mad at white folk.
But should we still
be mad about slavery?
You should. Yes, you should.
Yeah, because slavery is still going on in a different form.
Yes, we should.
That is true.
We're still being discriminated against.
Because none of the slave owners are alive.
A lot of people are looking at the old slavery when they need to be looking at the new slavery and identify what we're going through the new slavery, because we're not living in the old slavery anymore.
Yeah, I know what you're saying, bro, but it's not really slavery now.
No.
Not like it was back in the day. My great-grandfather was slave. He lived to be 30-something, which was old for, you know, the average slave during slavery times in America only lived to be 22, 23 years old. I think Google that.
You said 22, that was right.
22, yeah. Is that what it was?
Mm-hmm, 22.
So it ain't slavery like that.
No.
Right. But it's a different form of oppression
that
exists, you know.
They just hide it in numbers and
they're
the money,
also using
like
prison as a form of it as well. Because when you have a lot of these private-owned prisons, so they take a person and lock them up, and they ship them to this prison. And this prison now, I forgot how much it is to house a prisoner, so that's a bill, right? And then you'll ship them to your homeboy's prison, and that's a bill. So it's a form of it. They're still making money off of us, but we look at it, well, you committed to crime.
Well, you look at that guy in Alabama, the warden, Louisiana. He said, we're letting these guys out too fast. Mm-hmm. How are we going to keep the lights on that way?
I don't know. I'm like Richard Pryor now. Some of them niggas need to be locked up.
But he had to get on TV and say, we're thinking they reformed too fast. They not reformed yet. We letting them out too soon, I think. How are we supposed to keep the lights on that way? I was like, are you kidding me?
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's like the tennis, man.
Yeah.
But you know, they say Michael Jordan owned a bunch of prisons.
He probably do.
Probably making his shoes.
What's his name that used to be on The Price is Right? Bob
Barker.
Yeah, he has soap and something else in the prisons.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I know that for a fact.
Was he fixing the soap on purpose so that they would drop them?
Yeah.
No, he made a flip. Little bar soaps and little shampoos.
I know little bar soaps. Yeah, drop them. You got to bend your ass over and pick them up.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't those contracts with those prisons ain't no, I mean, they worth a lot of money.
Exactly. Exactly.
I used to work in medical for a prison for 3 years, and the bill.
You ever drop your soap?
Yeah. I worked there. I wasn't an inmate.
Okay, so
I was on work release. I got to go home every day.
So if you're in prison, you need to train your butthole to grab soap, sit down on it, not bend over.
Look, all I know is somebody making some money out there.
Soap. I just rinse on.
All right, so the thing I got, and I'm normally Sister J does it, but she was answering the question in such a great way. But the thing, Michael Jordan did indeed invest in private prison stocks.
I thought so.
However, Michael Jordan, who did so, isn't the same as the greatest basketball player of all time. The Michael Jordan you see circulating in prison investments are due to the case of mistaken identity. So the Michael Jordan that we know did not invest in private prisons.
Okay. Oh.
But it's a different Michael Jordan
that
invested in private prisons.
Okay. So it is a Michael Jordan, but not the basketball player.
Yeah, it's not the basketball player.
Okay. Well, that's good.
Yeah. Oh, somebody corrected us on the show too. Said that was
same
a different
name.
Yeah,
as a different Michael Jordan.
You're right.
Yeah. What Michael B. Jordan?
Right. I was thinking that. No.
Right. He too young.
Right. He too young. He can't get into it. So. Yeah.
But to your point though, DC, about being mad about slavery, I feel as though we should be everyone that in this whole world that's got some sense should be mad about slavery. But you don't have to act on it in this time. But you should be mad about
so you don't agree with Kanye. Slavery was a choice.
Well, I tell you what. If black people in America act like the Haitians do about their country, white people would have a problem.
They
would have
a problem with that country.
Because we savages. If we really wanted to rise up and do something, they know we are savages. We're going to kill everybody. Your kids, your family. We ain't going to leave nobody behind.
Who you talking
about? Which is all or nothing.
Oh, you ain't going to go with us?
He's talking about Mississippi blacks.
You ain't going to go with us?
What, if it's an uprising?
If it's an uprising?
I don't know, Bo. It's 40-something black folk over here.
That's a lot of the white folks.
300-something million. 40-something million black folk. 300-something million.
The numbers don't add up.
Hey, we definitely need some help from above. I got you.
And we don't own as many guns as they do.
Oh, they out there. They using air guns, militia. They practicing every
day.
Somebody
said, who is us? I know that's right.
Hey, there's a couple brothers out here. That's
a simple nigga, too.
Hey, there's a couple of brothers on 40 down to sell us out for a couple of white girls in yoga pants. Like, I don't want to revolt.
Nah, you know, I'm down with the people, man. Yeah, come with me. I'm down.
I'm down, too, but don't be doing no crazy stuff, man. Don't.
But I ain't trying to die. Well, I ain't when people be talking about, would you die for this and that?
I give you a good boycott.
I'll give you my best fight. But
yeah, that's not like somebody who got plenty of money.
Boycott.
He got plenty of money. He can hide. He got plenty of money. He can move around. Get away from it.
I think everybody in this room is living pretty good to where we don't need to do that. You know, let's compromise. I think everybody in this room lives well enough to say we don't need to do that unless we're just pushed and backed into a corner.
But
that's all I'm
just
saying.
Just say if they get your address wrong and they kick in your door instead of the door down the street.
I got a right to defend
myself. So now they done kick in your house. They ain't even supposed to be there. What you going to do now? They telling you lay down in your own house.
You better lay your ass down.
Right.
You going to shoot it out with the police.
You better lay your ass down.
Carlos said.
Police or people that invaded my house?
Well, you talking about the police kicking in your house?
Wrongly.
Throwing your lady on the ground. They throwing flashbangs and whatever it is, they wrong.
You ever been with a woman and
police
stopped you or something and would you deem to be mishandling the woman? You ever felt that helpless, man? It's happened to me.
So you saying you choked somebody out and the police showed up? What you saying?
They say you get pulled over for a traffic stop or something.
Mm-hmm.
And the police, you got one with the police pull out and...
And she crying.
Mistreating you or something. You totally helpless, bro.
Oh, he mistreating your woman?
Yeah.
And you just got to watch him?
Yeah.
Or you got to pull your gun and kill him and then it's you in court.
Pull your gun, try to kill him or he might kill you.
Right.
Kill both
and if you kill him, you probably won't make it to the stage. You'll probably be involved in a high-speed chase.
That actually happened to me, though, D.C., when I was living in Baltimore.
It's
a
helpless situation.
My heydays, yeah. And
She's at her heydays.
and
Queenpin.
I just in my mind, I was like, we good. Cause I already knew, I could see in my people's face that he was like, yo, the man in him won the step, but. And I was like, man, we good. Don't even worry about it.
Now, it's different if your old lady talk your ass into a jam.
I ain't do that, though.
I've been in that situation, too. I'll be like, shut your ass up.
Nah, he ain't got no business telling you. DC, you need to help him.
Yeah. He ain't got no business talking to you like that. Hey, shut your ass up.
Get in the car.
Let me deal with
this
white man. So we can go.
Get my ass locked up.
Yeah. Get in the car. Be quiet.
Shut the hell up. We'll be back. You listening to this race.
Fight for your people.
When bodies get caged, somebody got to be Texas. I'ma make it to the top, so I keep the faith and keep away from snakes. Middle fingers to the jakes. If you starving, most niggas won't feed you food. Never give a helping hand, so you must believe in you.
Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Seen nothing but trouble, baby. Nobody really understands.
Love homie malnourished, he ain't got dinner. And his mama shooting dope summer through the winter. That kind of shit that make the little shorty so bitter. And he'll probably kill a nigga for a chicken tender. When the last time he ate, shit he can't remember. Landlord said the rent passed through since December. Same clothes the youngin' wearing like every week. And he don't want no night sneaks, man, he wanna eat. Coming up in the ghetto made his heart numb. Went from a 25 to a 9 with a drum. I know this chick, but she really need a brain, man. But it seems as if the girl won't change, man. With this nigga, that nigga, that nigga. Slim fat nigga, white nigga, black nigga. It don't even really matter, nigga. Planning out steps just to make a pocket spat.
Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby.
Send a bag of pills, is all I really need to chill. Good cushion to refill, is all she really wanna feel. After sex, get the head still, is all I really need to chill. Roll up, pop some more pills, is all she really wanna feel. I say, bitch, you know it's Copperfield. Good weed, good drink, and a lot of pills. Got a thick red bitch, red bottom heels. Bitch flashing like she won't, but I know she will. See me getting money so she know it's real. Take her to the hotel, like she done deal. Bitch, love the fuck.
Y'all, you listening to DISRACE. I'm DC Curry with my crew here. Boy, you don't never know who's gonna show up at DISRACE. We be talking about controversy, Cat Williams. You talking about controversy? Oh, Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, from Houston, Showtime, Apollo, Def Jam. About 40 years deep, just like you and me, Bo.
Yeah.
Y'all show your love for the one and only, Teddy Carpenter.
How y'all doing?
What's up, Teddy?
What's going on, boy?
I saw y'all talking about all of the Mississippi murders. I mean, you know, the police officers down there and whatever the case being. The young lady is right. He should, everybody, no numbers. No numbers. You go to jail, and I see you when I see you.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and this type of crime, you know, because you know we were looking at that earlier, and they slapped a man all in the face with their genitals,
right.
Told him to, you know, do all this stuff and whatever case be. Now you got to go to testify about what they stuck in your booty hole and all that, you know, and whatever.
Dick in my mouth.
Like you say apology, you know, and forgiveness. You no.
I don't think I can forgive nobody for that.
Nope. Me either.
Nope.
No way. Ain't no way I forgive him. Nope. Ain't no way in the hell.
Can't have
I want to get my hand around his neck. That's what I want to do.
And nope. And it's demeaning to a man, and like you said, to get on the stand. And it's demeaning to a woman.
Well, like in the case of like Rick, where a woman got testified as to, you know, what happened to her.
So you
got to
relive that.
Blah, blah, blah.
You the one that, but you the one that was saying forgive.
Well, I said I understand. Well, I mean, I understand, but I understand why people say they forgive.
Again, forgiveness is not for the person; it's for the individual.
See, I hear people say that. I hear people say that, and you just got to live with it. Like sometimes you got to burn in hell. They should have known about you before you did it. They know about you. We got little cousins.
Depend on what it is now, Teddy. Depend on what it is now. Me and you were talking earlier today about burying the hatchet. You and somebody else that had beef for a long time. Man, some shit, you don't hold no shit.
Yeah, but they ain't stick they finger in my ass.
Right.
I mean, right. That's a whole different neighborhood.
You didn't tell me what they did. You just told me y'all had disagreements.
There's forgiveness and then there's forgiveness.
Yeah. You really didn't tell me what they did. You just told me y'all had disagreements.
Well, trust me. You know it, me. Trust me.
We said forgive. He said something about forgiveness and forget.
Forgive and forget. He never going to forget they stuck this finger in his butt.
They slapped that man around with they ding-lings.
With they ding-ling, man. Come on now.
In the face.
Forgive him for that. I ain't know where in the hell you forgive.
Well, I'm telling you.
Over knowing some white women.
I ain't no defense lawyer now.
Yeah.
But they ain't kill him.
Well, historically,
that's how they white policemen have killed. So, okay, I'm going out there now.
Bruh. I'm with
you. Take George Floyd, you take some of the other brothers that have died at the hands of the police. Would you rather take that or just get dick slapped on your cheek?
Well, I mean, if you put it like that, but what I'm saying is they almost, that's how they got caught.
Yeah.
Because one of the dudes accidentally shot the boy in the face.
In the face.
Yeah. And what? How they going to explain that?
Right.
So they take him to the hospital and then stuff start unraveling.
But I'm saying they could kill him, man.
I'm not saying they need to be exonerated. So you think I should forgive them
because they didn't kill him?
I think they should get 100 years instead of life.
Then he get like one of got 20 and the other got 17 years.
One of them got 40.
He can never argue with his woman again. You know, as soon as he say something, it come deep in his voice. You ain't say that to that man that slapped you all in the ding-a-ling, in the face of the ding-a-ling.
You should be like, babe, they had...
Birthday,
you should be like, babe,
shit with no tongue.
You
got no
tongue. You should be like, babe, they got guns.
Then they cut a tongue out.
Where you can text message. You ain't say that shit.
Right.
He can text message.
That's just savage behavior.
I mean, we shouldn't be laughing at it, but man, that's awful.
I'm from Mississippi, so I'm appalled about the whole
situation. I'm upset too, and I ain't from there.
I'm glad you from there, Bo. I'm glad you wasn't there. I'm glad it wasn't you.
Yeah, because
I'm glad you wasn't a victim in it.
I don't know, man. If it had been me, when I'd have got out, I was gonna look for somebody in his family. I'm just that way.
You know, I'm not preaching retribution, nothing, but there are some things, not necessarily for me, but for some people around me, if certain things happen to certain people around me,
it'll be hard.
I'm ready to go.
Yeah,
it'll be hard.
Yeah. Well, my mom said you shouldn't go to jail for justice. So people, you run your mouth too much. That's our problem. You shouldn't go to jail for justice.
You shouldn't go to jail
for
justice.
Who said that?
You shouldn't go to jail for justice.
Everybody trying to analyze that.
Yeah. You shouldn't go to jail for justice because
you saying like in retribute, right?
Exactly, because if someone do something to you, and then to your point, you say, "Oh, I'm coming to get them." You're already saying what you're going to do.
Well, you don't say, you can say it to yourself. You don't, right. you don't
that's
say
that's
it.
What I'm saying. You know, so justice is justice, so you shouldn't go to jail.
Jay, I think a lot of it would stop if there was more retribution.
Sure enough.
If people start showing up at these police houses and causing problems, I think a lot of that would stop it. You know what I'm saying? Police getting away with murder.
I think crime is going to decrease now in Georgia because it's open carry.
Yeah.
You got to think twice.
Yeah.
Right. Now, I've always carried.
And it's unfortunate because there's no more arguments
anymore.
I'd rather be,
even when it was illegal, I was like, I'd rather be caught with it than caught without it.
Because at the end of the day, you're going to say, oh, he threatened me. I fell for my life. I'm scared. You know, same old police tactic. And, you know, he looked like he was reaching. I saw a gun.
What I thought
you know, was a gun.
Right.
He black and he was walking my way. Right. You know, it's going, all that stuff is going to fit.
I think if that was true, it would have happened by now. And I believe,
it's going to happen.
What would happen by now?
Because it's happened in Florida.
But that's Florida. This is where I'm going with
open
this.
Open carry.
Open carry. Hold on. I'm going somewhere with this. I think when you see those issues, when those people did it in Buffalo, when those people like that, the white people and stuff, case these joints, I think having open and carry is beneficiary because those people, most of the time, they case those places this way. Like when they go to schools and stuff, that's weaker. They don't have a weapon. But I guarantee you, if they see a Family Dollar or like they see that grocery store and they see a brother like you and me or like you and all three of us got guns on our hips, they're probably going to rearrange. I don't think people like that want to be just confrontational.
I don't mean walking if they mine want, out if they, them. I'm just saying.
But I'm just saying, I guarantee they do not, enough
they don't
casing.
Know whether you got
Yeah, but I'm just saying they do enough casing. I don't think when they do these things randomly, especially the grocery stores and things like that, I don't think it's random. I think they target, they case it. It's no coincidence there's always these schools. They never go to a place that's heavily armed. If they want to kill black folks, won't they just go in the hood to where black folks can fire back? No, they go to places where they're a lot weaker and they feel like there are no weapons. But when they case a joint and stuff and they feel like they know people can rebut or fire back, they don't go there. I've never heard of a serial killer going in the hood.
But you added things as you were talking. Let's go back to the bare bones.
Okay, what we got?
The average person who is now carrying a weapon,
right,
who doesn't have really any training, just picked up a gun, didn't grow up with guns, like he got 1,000 different guns, can't tell you.
I love all his guns. I love all his guns.
I understand.
I love all his guns.
I understand.
I love all his guns.
But he just told me he had a pistol on his hip, and he almost pulled it out. So I ain't tell him nothing. I ain't saying nothing. But the point of the matter is, those people, weapons are like liquor. It's false hope. You know, when liquor comes around, everybody got that bravado now. You know, that liquor gives them
some
that bravado.
Do.
Well, guns are the same way. It's a whole bunch of people carrying guns, and they bad as a motherfucker when they, I don't know if I can cuss.
They bad as
a motherfucker when they got the gun.
Yeah,
or
some
when they
people
carrying
are
a gun, and all and ask, what? You said what? You know, right. Whereas they didn't have that weapon, it's a different conversation.
Yeah, some
so,
people.
So what happens is the confrontation is going to happen. Just because you got so many amateurs out
well,
there carrying
yeah,
weapons.
Well, yeah, no. Because I'm going to give you another example, bro. Me having my gun has kept me out of some physical exactly. altercation.
See, but you missed the part. Huh? You missed the part.
But what I'm saying is,
you've been carrying it for a while, and so you know better. You kind of know how to do it.
But what I'm saying
I'm talking about
is,
the people that don't
by
understand
virtue of the
what
fact
it does.
That I have this gun, I can't get no physical confrontation
correct.
With you.
Right.
Particularly if you don't have a gun.
Exactly.
Because I don't want to get to wrestling with you.
Correct.
You mess around taking
no,
my
no,
gun.
No, no. When I carry
so
mine, it's
I have,
the same thing.
I have
I
held myself back
understand.
From slapping or some bitch.
Just mm-hmm. so you
because
won't have no problem.
I got my gun.
Right.
But everybody's not thinking like
and
that.
We go, and we get in a physical altercation.
Think of it like this. You've been a little bitch all your growing up in school. You've been chased home from school. You've been slapped around. You've been beat up. You've been jumped. You're a little punk. There's a lot of dudes that joined the police department just for the same reason. So now they own the police department. They didn't all of a sudden got this this courage, you know what I'm saying, whatever the case be. Now they able to snatch up the same dude that whooped their ass when they was in high school or whatever the case be because
yeah,
now they got the law on their side. So
they
what
got
I'm
that
saying
badge
is,
and that gun.
The first part, and then military comes over. But the first part is what I said. I look at you as somebody who's very knowledgeable about how they handle themselves when they go out with their weapon.
I'm trying to avoid conflict at most, but however, there is a line.
Homicides have gone down in Atlanta since they did open carry. I thought it was the opposite. Homicides have gone down in Atlanta as far as like the shootings and stuff have gone down in Atlanta since they've done open carry.
That was an opening statement.
Yeah, so, I mean, I'm just saying, going your opening statement, I ain't hear the part that the homicides have gone down. Yeah, since it's been opening carry.
But like you said earlier, the white people, I mean, the police were fighting with some white guys. They didn't shoot none of them. I mean, we started before the show
started. Did y'all see that on Facebook? Where the police, I mean, these white boys were whipping the police ass.
Yeah.
They never pulled his gun out.
Nobody pulled a gun.
Never pulled their gun out.
They rattling with them, man.
It's a whole different thing. Even when they pull people over, you may be related to Judge so-and-so or whatever that lives in whatever county. When they, you know, pull over a black person, it's a different thought pattern.
I'm going to give you another example at the risk of getting put on social media suspension again.
Let's not do that.
All of the killing. When the last time? You got a lot of black police officers.
Yeah.
When the last time a black police officer mistakenly killed a little white boy?
They don't.
That, wow.
But what makes it even worse is that the black police officers, don't take it out on me. It don't seem like y'all step up when another white officer kills somebody innocent. It's like you guys don't say anything.
Case in Memphis, not the last one with Tyree Nichols, but it was a case before that. Mm-hmm. And it was five or six white officers, and they killed the brother. And it was one black officer there. He didn't step up. But when you're outnumbered like that,
they're going to leave him out there by himself on a call, and he's going to have to deal with it by himself. That's that hidden police. Yeah. I live with a police officer.
You think they'll set him up?
Officer, 35 year retired now. And we had these conversations all the time. And he was, you know, involved in the riots and, you know, on the Capitol Hill and all of that stuff and whatever. They held a lot of them back. They held the guards back. They held the troops back because they didn't want white folks to die. And if you pay attention to the timeline, Trump only when they started taking back over the police officers, that's when he started making the speech. Hey, y'all got to calm down. Before then, he was like, y'all have at it.
Yeah.
So you know,
I'm coming out there with you.
Well, taking it back to what Brian was saying, and to your point, that is true. A lot of times, black police officers do not step up because it is a unwritten rule that if you do, then you got to deal with us.
Right.
You know,
you think they set police officers up to get killed when the ones that do speak out and go against?
Yes, they do. And I know that for a fact.
Wow. And I don't think it's just straight there. I think sometimes it's just we ain't gonna respond to the call.
We're
going to give you a few more minutes out there to deal with them 12, 13 jokers that's on your head.
Since you say we
just
to
let you know.
So the percentage will go up, the percentage of you losing will go up, and it's still up to them. It's by the books.
Some of it is still with that slave mentality. I'm going to put you out there against your people.
Right.
Yeah. And I'm going to make you do what you do. And we're going to do what we do. And if you take up for them, when you need us,
that's the police officer.
We're going to turn our head away from you.
Like,
ladies and gentlemen, breaking news. I hate to interrupt.
Breaking news.
Former police officer just walked in.
and we on his hot pots.
The landlord.
Right.
And that happened a lot in Baltimore back in the 70s and the 80s. And I'm not calling names because some people are still alive, but... there was a police officer that really was for his people.
Mm-hmm.
And he did not, you're going to talk about the same thing I'm talking about. And because he wouldn't go against his people, they set him up.
Let's cut the chase. What extra mic at, Will?
But going back to Baltimore.
Give it to Officer Angelo.
Yes.
How did you feel? I was appalled. We all had the riots about the guy with his neck.
Come get me.
The guy that had in the back of the van with his neck. So when the riot came out, you just saw this brother open up on a female protester like he was fighting a dude. And I just did not understand why other cops of color didn't say nothing to the dude. I'm talking about the girl, she was just a protester, and he opened up on
her. She was a what?
Well, she was a protester when the man hurt his neck or, you know, in the back of the van, Freddie, whatever. Mm-hmm. So, you know, they was arresting the girl because she's a protester. And, you know, of course, she just looking like, why are you arresting me? But this brother cop open up on her like he was fighting Floyd Mayweather. Just, he gave about a four or five piece combo.
Well, I mean, I hate that because of the racial aspect. However, if you own the force, I mean, it's just me talking because this is how I am, bro.
Right.
I mean, if I'm with you, I'm with you. If we gang banging, I'm with you. If we open up on a female like that, man?
Well,
you know, I know, man, but you know, I'm just, telling you, I've been with Teddy. Teddy starts shit all the time, man. And I'll be like, you know, later on, I'll be like, man, I'm going to kill you. You know, I'm going to
He just got to do it, huh?
We were talking earlier today. I've been with Comic Man.
And he always starts up.
Man, I don't bother nobody.
Hey, them the main ones that do. Them the main ones that I don't bother nobody.
I'm caught because I'm with him. So I got to fight.
Yeah. In all fairness, Tater, most cats that say I don't bother nobody are the cats that be fighting.
You got to make a move.
Brother, trust me. I just want a nap, and I'm good. I don't want no trouble.
I can imagine. It's hard for you to tell... You black cop, you out there five cops. I would imagine that. It's hard for you to tell them, hey man, don't slap the shit out of Red Mahomper. He's talking shit, but you know, he's...
No, but then the thing about it is that, again, and to your point, so then we go and get John, and so I know I can't do jack to John, and John talking cash trash to me, because if I do something to John, then my white... counterparts are not going to have my back.
Right. Because like you see white people talk bad to cops.
That's like the boy in the George Floyd case. They had a little, was he a Chinaman or a Japanese?
Yeah, he's like a little Asian cop.
Some kind of Asian, either up or down. I don't remember.
Both. They were fluctuating that time.
And they put him in jail, but on the stand in court, they talking about he didn't do nothing. And the other guy was 20 or 25 years deep, Chauvin or whatever. How this boy been on the floor 30 days?
Right.
He ain't going to step up and say nothing to that boy.
No. That's true.
Because there's an oath.
Right.
Mm-hmm. But they trained to do that. And Angelo, I'm giving him a chance to speak a piece. But to my understanding, the police cannot shoot the wound. That's the first problem. Mm. I saw him shoot a woman dead in Chicago. She came at him with a broom. Man, shoot that bitch in the knee.
They got to shoot twice,
as I understood it now.
Mm-hmm.
And you're looking for the torso, the biggest part of the human body.
Yeah.
And you got to shoot the kid. You cannot shoot to wound. You cannot shoot to stop him. You got to shoot him.
To kill him.
Yeah, I don't agree with that. I just think
you're just trained to shoot body mass. I don't want to get a cop and everything a hard time.
That's why you shoot to kill black people.
Exactly.
Trained to shoot to stop the threat.
But if your muscle...
That's what they're doing. But I'm saying in some cases, you can shoot. We've seen it. We've seen it overseas. We've seen it in other countries where they can disarm people.
Right.
You know, and do certain things.
They take all kinds of tactical training. This dude is going quiet.
This dude is going crazy. It's 12 of y'all. It's one of him. Let him get tied and then jump his ass.
He got a crowbar.
Why do y'all have to shoot this man right now?
Shoot the man in the shoulder.
You know?
Yeah.
But if he come near me, I'm going to unload 12 bullets on him. That's not right.
I agree with you on that. But
let's ask Officer Charlie Brown himself.
Get him.
Yes, sir. I don't even know, as a former officer, are you allowed to discuss this?
Yeah, because I won't.
Okay.
Hey, Mike.
Is Mike on with him?
Yeah.
But police generally treat brothers like I treat snakes. We was at my farm today. You know how I treat a snake?
Hope just he blow like, his head off.
Just like a police treat brother. I tell the nigga, put your hands up. And if some bitch don't put his hands up, that's
his ass. Go.
Now I'm gonna say this: I'm gonna be upset if you use the Winchester and I ain't get called out there to help you out.
No, I'll be using my 410 on snakes.
Oh, okay.
It's spread. Can't miss.
Okay. Can't miss.
Put your hands up. And niggas say, I ain't got no arms.
I ain't got no arms.
Shoot the niggas. Did I say anything about your arms? Nigga, I said, put your hands up.
All right.
Now, what we got? What you got, boo? Why they get the mic ready?
Gets ready. They, they have a way, like, I have a watch that monitors my heart rate and all this kind of stuff, right?
No shit.
Okay.
They should have a way to test these white cops, black cops, whoever. How do your heart rate changes when you're in a certain situation?
I saw a study of that. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That way you would know not to put him in a black neighborhood.
Look, man,
if he gets all sweaty.
This shit is rigged and swayed for the police. I'm gonna tell you something, man.
I agree.
You seen all these crimes where it be a debate about whether somebody did something or didn't. So they give a nigga the lie detector test.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Have you ever seen them give a police a lie detector?
Never. I've never seen one. But
they ain't gonna get the police because they know he lying.
Yeah.
They ain't gonna get the police. I've never heard of police unless he was accused of a crime. But when there's a dispute between the policeman and a quote unquote suspect, they'll get a lie detector to the suspect. Right. They'll never say to the policeman to see if he telling the truth. We're going to hook you up to
these
wives.
Policemen got blue cars. Police's kitty guys got blue cars and stuff.
You know? Yeah, we hear you. Come on, officer.
That all depends on if there's a formal investigation on the officer.
If there's a formal investigation.
If you go to...
Internal investigation.
Correct. In Atlanta, called the Office of Professional Standards.
But OPS. I ain't never heard it just in public. But go ahead.
Yeah, that's not going to be in public.
It ain't going to be in public.
No, it's not going to be in public. Unless it goes to trial or something like that, then they can request it. But other than that, no. But as far as the shooting part goes, you are trained to shoot center mass.
I told you, boy.
That's what the training is, the center mass.
And are you trained also to shoot more than once?
No, you're trained to stop the threat.
Okay, well, the policeman I know retired from Chicago said you were instructed to shoot at least twice.
That may be in Atlanta. It's the threat to stop.
Yeah.
Okay. On the occasion when they're in the car, they trained to shoot through the window, through their own window. Is that right?
No, you're not supposed to shoot through the vehicle. Period.
You're not supposed to shoot through your vehicle.
No.
Reach out the window and shoot.
Because of the other. There's other witnesses, bystanders, you might...
You're not supposed to shoot out the window at all.
No, that's what I say. You're not supposed to shoot out the window.
You're
not supposed to shoot at a vehicle unless that vehicle is an immediate threat to you. You know, they got officers who shot some people in vehicles. You're not supposed to do that either.
No.
No.
Because it's not correct.
That bullet goes through. Now you hit an innocent bystander on the other side of that vehicle.
It ain't correct what I saw on TV. They train policemen. If there's something happening... And he's in his car.
Mm-hmm.
Not reach out the window and shoot. Shoot through your windshield. That's not true.
Not supposed to do that at all.
Yeah, because I could reject the other bullet.
On the news.
Too much can happen right now.
Yeah.
Not supposed to do that.
Fragments could come out, hit by
the... I'm telling you, in the city... You're a police officer, right? Not like
officer at the church or something like that.
In the city of Atlanta, you'll be fired. 100%.
Yeah. Right off the break, huh?
Huh?
Right off the break.
Yeah, City of Atlanta. I can't speak for California. I can't speak for Chicago. Right. City of Atlanta, you shoot through that window, you're going to be fired.
And if you shoot somebody in the back while they're running, you should be immediately arrested.
They shot Laquan McDonald in Chicago in the back 16 times.
No. Okay.
Hold on, let me restate.
If he fired at you, and I'm not going to say weapon because you're standing there with a gun, I'm standing there with a knife. I got a weapon, so that's legally now you can shoot me because you feel a threat even though you're over there. But if I'm known to have a gun, but we see it all the time, this kid didn't or this person didn't have a gun at all and get shot in the back. If this happens. You don't find no weapon out there immediately.
That's a different ballgame. Yeah, there's no weapon.
Immediately. Yeah.
Sure.
Because it's all about a threat. Once that man turns his back, what?
Well, that's like somebody breaking your
house. I was going to say, in Maryland, if you can shoot at a person, but the moment that you turn to flee and that person shoots you in your back, in Maryland, you're going to jail. So I don't know about anybody else.
That person has a weapon. That person has the ability to still shoot you.
Right, like
that. Well, I'm telling you, these are things that I
know. See, the key word is when he said weapon. again, weapon is anything. Weapon is that stick we were talking about. You said the broom.
I know someone.
Weapon is anything. Weapon is whatever you pick up. Weapon is this microphone. Or he had a metal object in his hand.
No, yeah, that's why that person.
And
was
what
like that
and what they call? I usually hear him saying imminent threat.
Yeah, mm-hmm. like what he was about to speak on was the guy that got pulled over, in the Wendy's, and I still hate to the day that the guy just didn't chill out and get in the car and go to jail or whatever. He'd still be alive.
Rashad Brooks, that's
yeah,
what you're talking about?
Yeah, so he got in a tussle with the cops and everything. And when he took off running, you got to understand he just got through scuffling. And this is the side I took the cop side on this one, because in a split second all that's going on, even though he had a taser, but, you know, just nobody knows what's going on. When he did that, you got a split second decision, unload or not. You don't know if it's a taser or a gun, because everybody's been fighting. You don't know what he got in his hand. This dude just gets up, takes off running, and then he looks back and point. So do I guess and let him live and he shoot my partner?
I have a hard time with that.
Or I go ahead and make sure I ain't got to explain to my partner's wife why I didn't pull the trigger and her husband is dead.
Let me tell you why.
That's all
I'm
saying. Let me tell you. Partner and say, get out, nigga, get out.
Yeah. Let me tell you why I have a hard time with that.
Yeah.
What he got pulled over. When you get pulled over, you get your information ran.
Not in Georgia.
So right. Guess what? I just got to fight. I just got to scuffling with you. The man got up, started running. Guess right. What? Live to fight another day. We gonna come get you. We got your car. Got all
thank
your information.
You.
We know exactly.
He was drunk in the driveway.
Okay, drunk. Yeah. Okay, drunk.
Yeah.
Even if he was drunk, you know, they got to scuffling. Whatever case, you got up, try to run. Whatever. Mm-hmm. I get you later. We'll all get you later.
But he.
That's what I'm saying.
At the point. You're right. At the point of that man turned around and shot the taser. He didn't point the taser. He actually fired the taser. And that taser is a threat.
Yeah.
That taser would hit that officer in the eye. That taser would hit the officer any kind of place and, you know, injure the officer.
But they have taser not from the distance he was at. The taser couldn't have did nothing to him from the distance he was at.
He was right there.
Yeah.
Totally incorrect.
That taser couldn't have did nothing totally to him
the initial, from that distance. The initial question, officer.
He'd have been found not guilty. The brother still alive.
I say on the podcast.
If the brother was still alive,
get off. Those guys
me too.
But the initial,
they'll get hired back, get all their money back.
The initial question,
right?
Is there not a group? I'm asking the question, really rhetoric, because I know the answer. Where if you're a member of the police force, you are. I mean, it's a group, man, and you're not hardly gonna go against another officer.
Is it a such thing? Right. They call it the blue wall?
Very
so. The blue line.
The blue wall.
It's
blue
very
wall.
True. You know, and it's there are times where you can or will go against it, but do they cover for each other? Absolutely.
Ain't no doubt about it.
They're fraternity. They're fraternity.
Big time.
I
won't deny that. Big time.
Ain't no doubt about it.
Yeah. So, mean, Angelo, how many times...
Which is natural.
How many times have you pulled over a brother with drugs and you kept the drugs and
Hold up, man. Hold up. Hold up, man.
You know, direct it. All right. Make him speak up.
Can I reveal this secret?
Yeah,
I don't think
that like that. He wasn't that kind of officer.
I didn't know if he was a church officer or what.
All right. Well, Al, I think it's safe to reveal this one, and I'm just going to give a tidbit to me if you can help with getting pulled over with your traffic stops. If you got a vehicle and you get the sticker with the black and blue, any more likely, probably won't pull you over or let you go when you got that in their back window. Possibly.
That used to be
right.
A big thing.
Right.
But because those things became to the point where they were
easy to get,
they went away.
Yeah, because I used to donate to the police fund. I had a little sticker on my car. And they said that would help. You know,
oh, yeah. I definitely did.
They would be like, pay this ticket. You're going to donate some more. Thank you, since you're a donator.
Right.
Yeah.
You can still get your state trooper sticker. Yeah, state patrol, unless you get the state trooper sticker and donate
see,
out
well,
there.
Well, I'm in D.C. I'm going to be honest with you. You see somebody pulled over on a traffic stop, that's when I say seriously unusual. Because they're not going to mess with you. Unless you just flying through the city or whatever. For the most part, we got this other crime to deal with. We not effing with you on this bullshit.
Yeah.
We not.
So we can drive 95. So we can drive 95 through Oxon Hill, Maryland. Ain't gonna say nothing.
No, DC. I said DC. 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 DC is different from Maryland.
Gotcha.
DC in that area. And what I'm saying is, those police officers, you kind of know when you go through. For the most part, you got to really be doing something for them to bother you.
Gotcha.
And that's just how it is, because we dealing with all this other stuff.
You can't be doing 50 and 45. Yeah, get pulled up.
Now, Angelo, is there such thing as quota? With a police officer, got to have a quota.
Yeah, I can answer that.
Yeah.
I mean, especially depending on the agency you work for, right? Because you got some of these counties that they literally live off of tickets and stuff of that nature, especially smaller cities and smaller counties. But the city of Atlanta used to have a quota, you know, but it's no longer an actual quota. But
you got 6 million people in the metro area. Right,
but you are expected to bring in numbers.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So they can go to court. So they can go to court and pay court fees and fines, and they might even dismiss it, but you're still paying the court.
I can go way deeper.
Everybody got to get paid.
The speed limit in America ain't over 75 nowhere. Where the hell you going to give me a car that do 124?
Right.
Yeah.
Beaumont, Texas. You can open it up down there now.
Okay,
85.
Okay, you come up with something.
I'm just saying. He said nowhere in America is not over 75.
How fast can you go then?
85.
Okay.
Beaumont, and then coming out of Albuquerque, New Mexico.
I think Vegas, certain parts of Vegas, can do 80. I ain't mistaken.
Okay,
that's a possibility,
man.
Too.
Okay,
damn, 80. Y'all just messing him up. DC, well, I was going to Oklahoma, yeah, it's 80. Highway 40,
but
you can do 80.
What's wrong having a car going 120?
For what?
Shoot, I'll tell you why in July. July, I'll let you know.
Well, a lot of these cars are foreign cars, you know, so they come from Germany and they do the Autobahn and all of that stuff, so everybody want a car that got no power.
They can fix a car where you could not get a
ticket. Is true.
Yeah, they got governors.
Where you could not get a...
But all it's going to do is somebody going to go in there and unfix it.
Well, that's all right. How many people you
let
think
that, let that Phantom only go 40. See what you do. Yeah. See if you're...
I did fine.
See, boy, why you going to
take
this
fine.
Away?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, okay. You get that thing converted. You'll get it mod. You'll
leave
get it mod.
On time.
40 miles an hour on 85? Mm-hmm. Man.
Yeah, they'll be running. Okay.
Remember, we'll be on 85 doing 285.
Really? How so?
I don't believe that. Bullhead be talking out his ass, man. I don't believe that.
You talking about if it's governor at 40 or just a car going 40, period? I'm
saying, so if you have a car that only goes 85
miles per hour.
He ain't got no mic.
Yeah.
Thank God, give him one. Let me reiterate what Bullhead said. First, let me say this. This is the Bullhead that said, who's that dumb shit he said a couple weeks ago?
Everything, duh.
Something about paper. How much paper he turned in and got, what he said, $1,000?
Yeah, right. And then we did the totals, it was $15.
But go ahead, Bullhead. Let's see what you got today.
If you got a car that can only go 40 miles per hour, that's the fastest it can go.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I got you now.
And I've had one of those.
It's going to max out because that's as far as it can go. Mm-hmm. You're going to wear the engine out. But if you can go a little faster, then you got a little bit more power.
That's not true. You ever been in traffic in Atlanta? You ain't going more than 40.
But I saw you on a lawnmower, and the thing blew up.
Now, if you got a car and you floor it, and because the transmission is bad, you still in first gear, and right, it's going 40. Yeah.
Yes.
But under normal circumstances, a regular car, you can do 40.
I find that tough because, you know, in Atlanta it might be a little hot, but up north it's cold. So the engine is still gonna stay cool, and that's you only get blow up and things like that if the engine is hot.
Yeah. So as long as you're pushing a red line, you should be all right.
Don't worry, Bullhead. Don't worry about nothing either.
Oh, okay. I was just
why y'all even taking that into consideration?
You know, because I was trying to figure that one out. I was.
He's dead from DC, so you know about the crime and shit. We was in DC last weekend. This ain't no lie, man. I was on the plane coming back here, and they said, you know, I was watching the news on my phone. 7 people were shot 1 block from where I was staying down.
Oh yeah.
Wow.
Hey, when I went to D.C., when I started comedy, went to D.C., the guy said, don't go that way. Go that way. What you mean? He said, stay above 12th Avenue. Don't go down past 11th Avenue. Remember, bad down that way in D.C.?
Hey, bro, all I can tell you is the neighborhood I live in is fine. You don't have no trouble. We can park that Phantom right out front.
Nobody talking about your neighborhood.
You know, so certain parts of D.C. is bad, but that's like hey, everywhere.
You ain't talking about your neighborhood.
D.C.
You want to try to diss your neighborhood?
Hey, D.C. ain't bad, but he live with a cop now. So.
Shit. Look, he retired. He retired. He retired. Ain't got no gun. I'm the person with the gun.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, my
cousin.
You
got the gun. All you got is what? That German Shepherd?
Oh, that's it, man.
You got the German Shepherd.
But we don't have no problems, man. I mean, certain parts of D.C. is bad. You got to just know where you at.
It's like Atlanta, man.
Dead cop.
That's it.
Boy, what you think about Cat Williams?
Shit. Let me address this.
Yes.
Cautiously. I think Cat is doing. Well, you know, I'm bullshitting. You know, I don't give a fuck about Cat. He can't beat me.
Oh, he can beat you and run it.
No, I didn't.
He'll outrun you. He'll outrun you.
Yeah, he can outrun me, but he can't beat me. Yeah.
He'll outrun you.
But no, you know, I feel like he was telling his truth. You know, we're in this business where it's a whole bunch of bull that goes on. And at the end of the day, you know, he broke down where he stood. Now, do I tell anybody to believe everything he say? Hell no. You cannot put in your contract, a man got to wear a dress to be in your movie.
Right.
That was bullshit.
If that's the case, Ricky should be suing right now, suing the studio, him, everybody else, and say, y'all forced me
to wear
because now he can come in there and say, me too.
Right.
It's, you know, that falls under that category. Right.
Me too.
So, I went to school with Ricky. So don't put him in the me
at
too
the end
movie.
Of the day, at the end of the day, you know, you had to really, I can't watch nobody for 2 hours. You know, so I saw the little clips and pieces and whatever the case may be. Is people in this comedy world that's grouped up and whole nine yards, just like when Monique came on there, she said some things too. I don't have a problem with Monique, but when you start opening it up to people's children and certain things like this, and you know,
I think this shit off limits.
That shit is cold.
Well, guess what just happened?
I think it crossed the line two or three things. I think crossed the line with Quake. I think crossed the line with talking about the guys' wives. Who are not in the business. Tori Hart is in the business, so she fat game.
Absolutely.
But the rest of them, I think that was out of line.
But did y'all hear who's suing him now?
No.
A librarian. Because he said the way he read that many books.
When we come back, go ahead.
I told you, liquor is the truth serum. Look, it's the truth, sir. He started drinking.
Let me tell you, man, Cat crazy like a fox.
Yeah, I ain't mad at him. Like, it doesn't bother me, you know, either or. But he's not the first person that spoke up. He's not the first person that ever spoke up.
Yeah, right.
Oh, he's some just of the one that, some of it I have a problem with.
Well, like
I understand what you're saying.
I have a problem with him saying Earthquake was illiterate.
Yeah, I had an issue, but I had more problem with Earthquake not saying something about it.
Right.
We went to see.
Yeah, we did.
Me and you went to see Earthquake, sat on the side.
He didn't address it.
And for 45 minutes did not address it. And I was hurt.
His boy's doing it for
him. He should have came on stage and read a statement.
Nobody can do anything for you. Nobody should do anything for you.
Awful. Yeah.
No, ain't no boy. Boys.
If you don't fight for yourself, I don't know who you're going to fight for.
Listen. I don't know nothing about that. At the end of the day, when you got brothers and you got in a fight and you got beat
That's
up,
right.
Your brother or your father or your mother or whoever walks you back down there and say, and you better fight. Whoop his ass or I'm going to whoop your ass.
Let me tell you something. I got a preconceived notion about a person on trial that does not take the stand himself.
There you go.
Right.
Hear my story.
There you go.
Hear my story. Now, Earthquake
from D.C. I never seen anybody just let it go. And he got up there and he was talking about.
Oh, he took the high road. He took the high road, nigga. Stop trying to pull him down.
Man, let me say this. I'm gonna say this. You and I ain't putting it on you. I'm putting it on me. Hollywood sometimes takes over. When people say you turn Hollywood. This is a version of it. Now, if you don't want to say he did, so be it. But what I'm saying, you know, I don't care if Dave Chappelle co-signed for you. I don't care, you know, whoever co-signed for you. At some point, you're supposed to say, you little bitch motherfucker, let me tell you where I stand.
Right.
Now, I ain't going to read this motherfucking book and tell you, But I'm a damn sure tell you off the top of my head. You feel me? Because guess what? You on stage. That is your domain. You supposed to be a killer. Earthquake's a killer. We agree that on stage.
I'm gonna tell you.
Yeah. So when you on stage,
break my bar now.
I
think he took the high road. However, he took the high road. However, certain things, if you accused of and you do not aggressively defend yourself,
right?
I have a problem. It's like Dwight Howard when the guy said he was gay, and he said, "Well, what business are you?" Something like that.
What business of yours is my sexuality? Yeah.
I like,
big old pump.
Okay.
Don't talk about leave my wood or something like that.
Yeah, yeah. What business is yours? There's certain things some bitch say, and you be like, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Do you ever see, you remember the Little Rascals?
Yeah.
And when they used to say something and it didn't make sense, and love a little joke would be like,
right.
Do that? I did that through the whole show when I saw him. I just wanted him to listen. People came to see you, just like they came to see Chris Rock.
What are you talking about
when
now?
When Chris Rock got slapped.
We did a show in Baltimore the other night. And after our show at the arena with him, we went to see Quake. He was at the club. And I was going expecting him to address, he my boy, expecting him to address. That was the big issue.
Yeah.
And we were going expecting him to address it.
He may have done it before on stage. But he just didn't do it that night.
Yeah, but
you supposed to do that shit.
Yeah,
because
he got 15 minutes just on that.
Yeah,
and people went to see Chris Rock just to see what Chris Rock had to say about Will Smith. You feel me? Now Quake didn't get slapped, but what I'm saying is,
he did get slapped.
Loved, I mean, I would have loved to see him speak on it. Yeah. Now, if you don't want to dog him, you don't want to whatever it is you don't want to do. But what I'm saying is, I would just like to see you speak on it.
Where you stand.
So to your point, because Chris Rock, it took him a minute before he did a
That was financial.
He was selling business. He was selling them tickets. So, he waited the right business. Time. So, and he was doing business.
Absolutely. Different levels. Different levels. No.
No.
Different levels. No.
So what if he was to come out?
A comedy club is a personal.
Well, you compliment me all you want. I do the same thing. I get in your ass, and then at the end, I say, "Oh, I'm sorry, Angelo. You know, I didn't mean that."
Correct.
But he also said he should have said that.
You gotta,
he did say
I ain't mean that.
See, I don't know about all that. I don't hang on nobody's words like that. I just know what you did say that I heard. Which, if you said something afterwards, or the next day, or when you wasn't drunk.
Let me tell you something. Teddy comic, I'm a comic. We in there to hear his editor, his rebuttal. And I guarantee you, 90% of the people that were in there were expecting to hear him address that one way or the other.
Yeah, because a comic club is a personal setting.
Yeah.
And
they were there to hear.
Yeah.
This is the home team. They came to your home game to hear what you got to say about what them folks said about you. And you didn't address it. You didn't say anything.
Hmm.
Somebody said at least.
Now, if you were, let's say, Kevin Hart.
Mm-hmm.
And whatever. I can see Kevin not cussing him out, but Kevin probably would say something too, but I can see Kevin not, you know why? Because his money corporate.
That's what I said.
It's a different tax bracket.
I probably shouldn't say that, but I'm going to say it.
Talk to us.
Cat went at Ricky. So I talked to Ricky.
Okay.
You know.
Yeah.
Private conversation. And I said, Ricky, the fuck you letting him on for? You like buying down to this?
Ricky to the high.
And Cap, my boy, too. I said, Ricky, you buying down?
Ricky actually promoted his concert.
Yeah, but Ricky with the high road on it.
It was corporate.
Yeah.
It was corporate because Ricky.
He got a lot to lose.
I don't know if I can say this or not.
He got a lot to lose.
He ain't tell me don't say it. Ricky got a deal with Disney. So he can't afford to be in no nigga squabble, quote unquote.
But see, even for me, on Ricky, for me, that's exactly what I'd have said. I said, oh, I heard what he said. And the old Ricky would have said some other stuff, but the new Ricky got Disney. So I'm going to let this one go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have a good day.
Yeah.
Yeah. He could have said that. That would have been harder, but
okay,
we get it.
Go get your money.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
then come your back. Bank. Yeah, when you come back.
Yeah, but it just you the way me? Ricky did, he just seemed like just kind of soft, man.
Ricky, Ricky, go sing.
Yeah, Ricky did it like somebody
don't give a shit
squashed him in his sing. Arm or something. And yeah.
Ow! He gonna, you know, he gonna make Cat a character but I in the next Princess and the Frog.
I understand. He didn't want to get in no back to back.
I get it. Like I,
and I think he should have said that, like he said to me, like I'm telling the world now, Ubi don't mind.
Right.
I think he should have said that.
Yeah,
well,
Ricky.
I got some shit I can say.
Yeah. Yeah, Ricky represent Alabama State University. Like you know how we know it. You know how
I
we do it.
I just want to know, you know, I heard it, he heard right. it, whatever. And you say, hey, listen, y'all, I heard it. Now, I know y'all want me to go there and slap the taste out of him, but let right. me tell you why I'm not going to do
can't
that.
Do.
Because A, B, and C, and this is where we stand right here. So I got to go get this money. And I'm gonna see y'all when I get back.
And now
everybody would have been like, you know what, my man.
He just said, I don't want to deal with it. So would that make some less of a man?
You said what?
Yeah.
Really?
In a comedic sense, JJ said.
Maybe it was, but what I'm saying is even if it's true, he's saying most of what Cat said about Ricky is true.
This is what he said. He don't have a mic. He said most of what Cat said about Ricky is true. No, that's not true.
I don't believe
Cat went in there and told him Hollywood producers.
I ain't believe that myself.
This man,
he was talking about his talent. He was talking about his talent and things apart. Yeah, now, his movie role, you know, he can only fit
my movie role. Two things can be true.
My rebuttal, just off the cuff, would have been: you was in next Friday, and Ted Cruz came in there and was sticking his dick in your ass. You know, I mean,
what's worse, a dress or a dick?
But
you said what happened? I missed all that. I missed that whole thing. What happened?
Well, he tried.
He
Ted Cruz was trying to rape him in the bathroom.
Trying to rape who?
Cat Williams.
Oh, Terry Cruz. Nigga, you said Ted Cruz. I was like the no. You talking about the little the white center? Boy there in the center?
Ain't that the
That's
center?
What I'm thinking. Yeah. The little white boy in Ted, he tried to do what now?
I'm just saying.
Terry Cruz.
You listening too hard.
That's a rebuttal if you want to go that route.
I'm from D.C. That,
and
that
I'm
accent
going that route
went right past me, bro.
For a comic.
Right.
That's easy picking, man.
Easy picking. Yeah.
But he didn't go there. God bless him for taking the high road. That's what y'all need. That's what you need to do, Mo, boy.
Yeah, I'm like, hey, so why not? Yeah.
That's what you need to do, Bo.
Wait, I ain't got no high road. Yeah, I'm taking that dirt road all the way. I want that dirt road.
Y'all know how to survive out here in these
streets.
I'm
going to survive just fine.
When we come back,
hey,
I got
Bo,
a man.
Just fine.
When we come back, I got a man going to kind of school y'all.
Yeah.
I want him to come on a regular. He going to school y'all on how to survive in these streets. We got Joe McKnight. He's an insurance company owner.
Mm.
And I asked him to come on. He was State Farm. I asked him to come on and talk about the importance of the various kinds of insurance. Normally, he can correct me if I'm wrong when he comes on. Black folk are underinsured.
Yeah.
Can you get insurance and slap the shit out of somebody? Is there any kind of insurance
today? I know I am.
We'll be back. You're listening to DISRACE. We'll be back.
I'm going
to
buy some of that.
With Joe McKnight.
Slap the shit out of somebody's insurance.
I'm just drunk enough to drop a hit. Gotta do it like a mission.
Ha ha, that boy caught on fire when TS put his ass.
Fuck you,
fuck
and you, and you, and you, and you. Wait till I hop out the new coupe on them. Rats got a whole lot of juice on them. AP Diamond, they best cook us. Zaza Lao, every place for much. Freaky little bit wanna touch on my butt. Go around 100K, feel like money. For what you thinking, I broke out the Porsche. Lay little nigga, been feeling like money. Spit 40K rocking out of Dior. Lay little nigga, been feeling like money. Been fucking all of these whores. Lay little nigga been feeling like money. Fuck you, and you, and you, and you, and you. Fuck your mama, your sister, your cousin, your daddy, your auntie, your brother, your bitch, your dog, your cat. Don't give a fuck all of y'all. Fuck do you mean we on all?
To the place where danger awaits me, and it's bound to forsake me. And I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby.
I'm trying to make it out my city, cause my city killer. Trips to Anguilla, far from jungles with gorillas. I gotta make it for the simple fact, I'm not a quitter. Rest in peace to Terry Berry, one real nigga. Whole lot of niggas hate like racism, so I dive inside my own dreams for escapism. It's gotta be a better way, I need some better days, instead of red tape with blood stains where bodies lay. I seen a nigga get arrested just yesterday. The streets are chess, not checkers, so we call the case. The streets is not a game, it ain't no replay. When bodies decay, then meet the pearly gates. I'ma make it to the top, so I keep the faith and keep away from snakes, middle fingers to the jakes. If you starving, most niggas won't beat you, fool. Never give a helping hand, so you must believe in you.
Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Well, I ain't seen nothing but trouble, baby. Nobody really understands.
Little homie malnourished, he ain't got dinner. And his mama shooting dope summer through the winter. That kind of shit that make the little shorty so bitter. And he'll probably kill a nigga for a chicken tender. When the last time he ate, shit he can't remember. Landlord said the rent passed through since December. Same clothes the youngin' wearing like every week. And he don't want no night sneaks, man, he wanna eat. Coming up in the ghetto made his heart numb. Went from a 25 to a 9 with a drum. I know this chick, but she really need a brain, man. But it seems as if the girl won't change, man. With this nigga, that nigga, that net. Slim fat nigga, white nigga, black nigga. It don't even really matter, nigga. Planning out steps just to make a pocket fat.
All right, already. We back. And before I bring on my man Joe McKnight, the insurance expert, I'd also like to say, Cookie Hall just walked in. Cookie was slamming with me. We were in, where were we, Cookie?
Philadelphia.
You're gonna try to make it hard on me. You can't make it hard on me. DZ Care.
Oh, yeah. Right.
And we've been touring, Teddy, myself, and some more. Teddy, he, you know, tried to blow you out the water and stuff. You know that old school shit, man. Huh? Hey, JJ.
Anybody making you double what you making, you need to punch them in the mouth.
Try to blow me.
You need to see if they can, you need to see if they can take a punch.
There you
punch.
Go. Don't hate, man.
I know, man. His stuff shine, extra shiny, boy. That when that check come, man.
Don't hate, man.
They hand me my check through the, like almost like a back pass, like. Dang.
Like, you killing them, boy. That good show, DC, Louisville, Baltimore, wherever the hell we were. As promised, ladies and gentlemen, as promised, you know, DISRACE is about DISRACE, and I think it's a big, I think it's a serious concern. Yeah, amongst us, insurance, man. Burial insurance, various insurances, you know, and all we know basically is car insurance and basically liability.
Liability, go-to.
Not full coverage. But we blessed tonight to have in our midst insurance expert, insurance company owner, State Farm, ladies and gentlemen, Joe McKnight.
Hey, thanks for having me, DC. You know, it's an honor to be here first and foremost because you are a national treasure.
Well, I
you've been in the game for a long time, man. Films, BET, all of that, man. And I think, I don't know about the like buttons, but they should be pressing them like buttons right about
actually,
now.
Actually, you know, I'm excited. We get them both. I get likes and I get dislikes.
Yeah,
so it don't matter.
Yeah, yeah.
It don't matter. The person can't dislike it unless they're watching, so whatever. But
talk to me. What you want to know?
Man, we're glad to have you. I mean, in general, I think the importance of insurance is ignored a lot of time by black folk. I think in general, black folk, with regards to insurance, cannot rationalize because it's not an asset that you see.
Right.
It's not a tangible asset. And a lot of times,
can't grow it.
If we have it at all, we underinsured. So Well, so when black folk die, you got to get a GoFundMe page.
That's not cool at all.
Black folk house burned down, you got to go get a GoFundMe page.
Put somebody's mother's house up for, you know, get money out of it. Yeah.
And I've had that. I've had those situations. You know, I've had close friends who I talked them into getting insurance, and they finally get it. And then because they rather, you know, go maybe get an outfit, or they maybe want to go get a, you know, another car.
Yeah.
Right.
Don't pay the insurance.
And then they don't pay their insurance. And then I had a particular gentleman 4 months after he called me to tell me he wanted to stop his insurance, he passed away with no insurance.
Well, it kind of makes sense for him not to get it, you know.
Yeah, but see, you know, like, you know, I don't want to overwhelm everybody with the different terms and different things. Yeah. So let's just take life insurance, for example, and just call it income replacement.
Mm.
So if you got a partner, you know, whatever your lifestyle is, or you got a wife or a husband, and God forbid you pass away.
Yeah.
The average funeral cost is $14,000.
Well, let me stop you right there.
You're here. Let me stop. Yeah.
Not if I pass away. That's not my concern. My concern is if somebody around me passed away and I got to pay
$14,000. Well, that's what we talk
but
about.
No, you're right. I'm
no, but
talking,
that's why
man.
We call it income replacement.
Yeah.
Because if you in a relationship with somebody, more than likely you're not paying one person is not paying all the bills.
Is that right?
Two people, well, what? I mean, you know, some, well, you know. But the thing is that when that person passed away, the average funeral.
Yeah, go ahead.
The average funeral cost is $14,000.
$14,000.
Not that the average black funeral or
any funeral. Period.
How much for cremation?
That's all a part of that. You can go which way you want
to
go. You might save. You might save on
some. To get burnt up.
But listen now, if you keep it at the $14,000, what happens after that? So now me and you been sharing the bills. You got $40,000 on it. The other person got $25,000 on it. So let's pick somebody who dies. If the $25,000 person dies, now where's that extra $25,000 going to come from, DC?
Yeah,
so you got to set yourself up. So then, how you want to look at it is, all right, I'm not going to go eat out for a couple of nights a week like I normally do.
Not going what?
I'm not going to eat out a couple of nights like I normally do.
Oh, you mean like.
You
see.
Let me ask you a
question. Oh, no, well, eat out is what's up. I'm almost there.
Okay.
So, you know, you don't eat out like you normally do.
Yeah.
And then what you do in turn is take that money and keep putting it towards your life insurance. Because you don't want to be without that extra income. Because now, not only have you lost somebody, now you're going to lose lights, you're going to lose, you know, food. You're going to lose a lot of stuff, man. And you got to have that.
So we have a question.
Okay.
It's
go ahead.
What is the difference between term and life?
That's
a whole.
A whole. That's a good point. Now, if you're a Dave Ramsey person and you got it together, your diversity in your portfolio, and you got your 401 going, and then you also got other investments, term is going to be the best way for you. Because what does term mean? Term means for a certain amount of time, at the end of that, you are guaranteed to get a certain amount of money.
If you don't die.
But black people, no. If you die, term is just straight. You don't get no bread from term.
Okay.
Now, whole means you ain't got your shit together, you're not invested in nothing, your money is all over the place, you just shooting it. Then you need some whole life, because whole life is gonna give you a cash value at the end of 5 years, 10 years, you can borrow that money, or if you don't wanna borrow it, you can just deduct from your overall death benefit. Make sense?
He just described me.
One guy said, why would he put $1 million insurance on himself? And he died, and his wife go out with JoJo from Burger King.
But I got
yeah, but see, that's like the forgiveness thing she was talking about earlier.
This term for everybody. What number, you know, 100, 300, 700, you know, and this is just layman's terms.
Amount of money do you want to be insured?
No, just layman's terms, because a lot of black folks think like this.
We make a certain amount of money a month. You know, I may not have X amount of dollars. What number could I pay $125 like a cable bill that I can have some decent insurance to cover myself where I ain't gonna bust my head open?
Well, then what you do is you do what they call a financial analysis. So if the total income of the house is $2,000 a month, then so what you wanna do is multiply that by 10.
20,000.
20,000. And remember, we're gonna call it income replacement tonight, not life insurance, right? So then you take that 20,000 and then you know that's where you need to be if the partner dies. And then in that way, you'll still be covered at least for that amount of years.
For how many years? Long?
10. We just multiplied it by 10.
10.
Mm-hmm.
So we're talking about if breaking down to how much a month. So we're talking about.
Well, and that's your personal financial analysis is going to determine what is going to be based on where you need to be. But now, the problem is, if I tell you it's going to be $100 a month, and you're like, ooh, I can't do 100.
I can do that. Mm-hmm.
You follow what I'm saying? Yeah. Then now you got to start, you start hemming and hawing.
What can I give for 50?
That's only 25. That's
right.
What
then what we do
that's is, what we be the high week.
But that's only 25.
What can I give for 75 a month?
Right. It's only 25 a week. Don't go to Starbucks or whatever, right?
So
let's say you, like my man is saying, I'm just going to do the 50. Okay, fine. Do the 50, but no. You better have a backup plan, you dig, for what that income replaces.
So you're saying if you do the 50, don't try to get no expensive cash to just get you a pine box.
Well, we still, the 14,000 is going to be included in that bread.
Yeah, that's in that.
So the average cost is 14,000. So that's not even a conversation no more. I'm trying to get y'all to focus on that income replacement.
Everything I notice you're saying, you know, income replacement as if you got a other half. There's a lot of people in here don't have another half.
And that's okay.
So they single.
So now let's switch it up. Yeah. Let's switch it up. For the single mother, bless their hearts, they need to focus on insuring their children.
Right.
Because now you got 8-year-old, 10-year-old, 15-year-old, open carry. Yeah. What's gonna happen when them kids pass away? So now you see what I'm saying. So then you just switch your situation. But then even if a single mother, when she passed, the grandmother's gonna be there. This, you know, somebody else has got to stay behind and take care of these kids. So they're gonna need income replacement.
So if you're a single mom, you got a kid that's in and out of jail, in the gang, you need to get insurance on it.
Definitely.
You.
A lot of innocent kids get killed. It ain't just gangbangers getting killed. What's the boy's name in Kansas City? He went to pick up his little brother, and the man shot him through the door. He ain't died, but you ain't got to be no gangbanger to get killed. Some of these kids getting killed ain't done a damn thing.
Did we answer that person's question that was on the thing?
I'm quite sure. I don't know. Okay. So what you're basically saying is preparing black people minds to... for life after death. Don't just be concentrating on the burial. You have to live after the burial.
That's right, because if you a grandmother or auntie, right, and now you got these kids because mother passed, you know what I mean, the single mother passed.
Why you do go like this?
But generally.
No, I didn't go like that to you.
Generally, Joe, though. Yeah. Like, say I buy one of them policies and don't nothing happen. Do I get any money coming back?
Now we talking about term.
That's
versus
term.
Whole.
Yeah, that's term.
Term, there's no bread coming back.
Yeah.
Whole is more bread, there's some bread coming back. But now you're talking about more of a premium outlay on a monthly basis.
But if
that's the hard part for black people. Do you see? They like, I think, you know, I need that bread. What do you need it for?
When the money start coming back, will it accumulate? Will it ever catch up to what I paid into?
Oh, definitely. Depending on the policy you get, let's say you get a $100,000 whole life policy, it could turn out to be $120,000 at the end. So now you get a return.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
I believe if you
that you can use as collateral if you're trying to get a loan or something. I heard someone say that.
Well, right, you take the money out. Mm-hmm. And then again, like I said a few minutes ago, you take the money out. But then now you can take the money out and you can say, well, you know what? I ain't paying this shit, Mac. And then you just decrease your overall value. So if you borrow 20, you got a whole life policy of 100. You take that, I'm just using arbitrary numbers.
Right.
You take 20 out, you can say, I'm not paying it back. and then you turn around and just decrease your value to 80,000.
I believe when kids are, a certain age, black kids, if y'all want insurance to increase, for them to be able to go to school at, let's say, sixth grade, seventh grade, to learn financial literacy and insurance at that age early, because a lot of times we just, as black folks, we just wing it. Mm-hmm. We get to a point, I hate to say it on the air, and I shouldn't even say it, like,
you say it, man.
Come on, say
but
it.
It's one of them things where, you know, I just got health insurance because I knew, you know, I was going, you know, I was ducking and dodging and weaving, and then the money come in, I got to put it over here and make sure that's straight and such and such and whatever the case would be. I just got it. You
thank
know,
God for Barack certain, Obama. You know,
yeah, no question.
Don't sleep.
But the point, the point is, if we start learning at an early age, you know, classes and whatever the case would be, I think it will
change.
That's
why I brought him on, man, because he done answered 20 questions I had already tonight. Mm-hmm. Now, can you get insurance on anybody? Like, you know, I got some sick people. But knowing that that policy will eventually pay back, can you get insurance on anybody regardless of their health?
Well, now, you know, you got some people with HIV, you got different diseases and stuff going on. So from an underwriting perspective.
I'm glad you said that. Go ahead.
Yeah, what we're doing. This is this race. You know what I mean?
Man.
So that's why I'm grateful you allowed me to smoke my cigar.
No, man, do your thing.
Hold on, let me
finish this point. But
I forgot my point.
You said because I asked.
Oh, right. Insurance on anybody. So the underwriting is going to determine, because they're going to ask you those questions.
Yeah.
And then there's another back door that also can see your medical records.
Yeah.
So they'll know if something went down. But yeah, you can get insurance on just about anybody.
Your question then, remind me, I got a question come back to you on that. Mm-hmm. What were you fix, say, Bo?
I was going to say, he explained it then, like medical records come up.
Okay.
I was at the doctor, the nurse told me, don't ever tell somebody you smoke, or don't ever tell them, let them figure it out. That's what she told me.
Okay, well, that's on her, because, you know, it's a compliance thing for me. You know, I ain't just going to sit here and say,
don't say whatever.
If you can get insurance on anyone, are you saying you
at
have
price,
some type of relationship with that person? You just
can't you could be what they call the owner of the policy. Mm-hmm. So, you know, now we're getting, you know, but like, say, for example, a businessman like DC, whoever his employees are, he can get insurance on them.
Without them knowing?
No, well, they got to know because they got to sign it.
Because I would get something on here. He getting a little older.
Hey, I was just sitting here.
You can do that.
I was just sitting here thinking, man.
Now,
they still got to sign.
Here's my question. I know this is not laughing matter, but this is laughing show.
Well, that's what we're here to do.
But this is not laughing question. I'm very serious.
Okay, go ahead.
You take a man with HIV positive, Magic Johnson.
Okay.
You heard of Key Man Insurance?
Key man insurance was the term I was getting ready to say if you have employees and stuff like that. And if you're in the hip-hop or industry like that, those cats are getting, they're insuring those artists.
If you are...
Key man insurance.
If you are, if you are, for example, an officer at a bank, if you are part owner of a bank, and I've known some, they all have key man insurance.
That's right.
Now, you tell me how Magic Johnson can own a bank, can own Starbucks, and own part of the Dodgers. How in the hell can they afford to buy key man insurance for him?
Well, obviously, they got the bread
Lord
in
the
that
London.
Situation. Well, there's different things, but let me just tell you about this. If a person has HIV, then they're going to come under underwriting in a different level, a different tier. So a person with HIV will probably be like a tier 4, which is a higher level on the underwriting scale. It's definitely possible.
Okay.
I mean, in this day and time, you know what I'm saying? It's out there. It's a lot, you know. And, you know, I have customers in those type of situations. But what happens with that is you better know your premium is going to be higher than it is for...
Right. But it is attainable.
Oh, yeah.
That's good to
know. Well, let me ask you this. You got family members that's close to the end.
Okay.
You're like, well, shit.
Well, how old are they? What's the sickness?
All right. 70, 73.
Yeah.
My dad at 98. Sickness
is unknown.
Yeah, see, just so sick. So now it's an underwriting
issue.
Well,
better yet, no sickness, just, you know.
Just getting in the
head tight.
And that would be just right, just
up.
Old, huh?
Yeah, just old.
Yeah, but now that would be an underwriting
so
situation.
My question, my question is that a good bet? Like, say, hey, you know what? Go ahead and put money up this next 7 years.
If they would let you have, if underwriting passes that insurance and it goes through, that's a hell of a bet. That's a good bet.
Let me ask you this. How much time?
I got four people.
But it's based on age. It's based on health situations. It's a lot of different things.
I just know.
Involved.
I just need this like a casino. I just need to know.
You can't be playing poker.
Don't kill your daddy.
He's playing poker. You can't be playing poker.
Don't go kill your daddy.
Now we're talking.
Let me ask you this.
You heard me talking.
How much time you paying insurance for before it can pay off? Like if you're paying for 6 months, something happens to somebody.
Is it a good investment?
Is it a good investment?
Hell to the yeah, it's a good investment.
And another thing you said too is very important. People that have that's raising gay children, now's the time to tell them, look, my insurance higher because you're doing the wrong thing.
You mean if they have HIV?
Yeah, you need to stop them. Well, too late then. Hell, if you got HIV, it's too late. I'm saying stopping them.
But just gay children don't have a higher premium. If your child is gay, you don't automatically have a higher premium.
Come on, man, that ain't going to be. Stop now.
You don't have mic.
No,
man. Get a mic.
There's no question on the form that says, is your children gay?
Okay.
You know, that's obviously a joke, man.
Yeah, can't do that.
Yeah, there's nothing like that on the form. It has to be relatable if he's saying that we find out that child has HIV, then now you're talking about a particular situation that the underwriters will look at. And like I said, the highest tier, you probably go to a 4, which means that person's going to pay more money.
Now, does life insurance work like property insurance? If you live in a zip code that's bad. You know, they consider
not to
bad.
My knowledge. That's a good question, but not to
my
knowledge.
That's a hell of a question.
Yeah, not to my knowledge.
Broke clock.
Not to my because what you just saying. What you saying is that that's some racial profiling
exactly.
Like crazy. Right. So there's no way I can say that that's a real thing. I can't say that's a real thing, man. But and I don't believe it's a real thing to be honest with you. But. Again, underwriting.
I think you need to ask Jake. Seem like Jake might know.
Jake is my son.
He don't know about that part right there.
That's my son.
But your lifestyle, like the job that you may have, that's
a part of it.
Part
yes, it does. Now, again, tier
well.
One, tier
smoking,
two,
smoking,
tier
drinking,
three, tier
right.
Four, all
you
of that.
What's
the highest tier?
If you got a high-risk job.
Four. Gotcha.
Stuff like that.
Yeah, like if you dropping out of airplanes, if you know, police officer, he's gone.
Yeah.
If you're in a police mode or something like that, it's gonna be a higher premium. But then now you work it out. You know, again, do that analysis first and find out how much income replacement you're gonna need for auntie or whoever, if you're in a single mother situation or if you're in a partnership, find out how much bread you're going to need when that person grows. And
right,
multiplying by 10 is the best way to do it.
So a question such as, have you ever been shot before, things like that? Are those
they don't ask you that.
And the reason why I'm asking is because we're living in a society now that...
But they will say, are you a felon?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, that type of thing. They will ask you that.
Mm-hmm. Well, how much
and
these insurance agents
the
make?
You can't get insured.
How much
man,
these insurance
see,
agents
you know
make?
He's from D.C. because he in my trying to be in my pockets right now.
He's
not
agent.
Know.
He's
a
no. He owned the building. He owned the joint. Right. He owned his own agency.
Right. But
right,
you
so
in my pockets.
Much,
I ain't gonna let you be
no,
in my
not
pockets.
Not you, but you gotta pay people.
I ain't gonna be like Earthquake. I'm gonna tell you straight up, man. Get out my pockets, man. Get out my pockets, man. Get out my pockets,
man. Gonna break bad turntables on us.
Get out my pockets.
So, tell me this on the underwriting. You know, because it's unfortunate a lot of young people getting slain in the streets.
Right.
So you know, if you a mother and your child is in a gang, or he got tattoos on his face and you just know he gonna die soon. How does that work?
That's right.
Do y'all ask, do we got any teardrops? What gang is he in?
Hey, shout out to Weight Ball over there. Shout out to Weight Ball. But look, man, that's what I was talking about earlier. You wanna get insurance on your children, man. Definitely. And it's least expensive. Now, hopefully they don't know their kids is in a gang. And they get their kids insured. And then so God forbid something happens, now you are there to be able to move on with your bread and your money and all that kind of stuff. And if you don't have insurance on your kids, then in a way for to me, then you're not really thinking this thing through.
So
as
can well. You, I mean, that's better
about making what about two of them kids ain't Jewish? Should you insure the three that's Jewish?
You definitely should insure. Depending on your pockets, you should. If you're just a stepdad or whatever, I would definitely insure my kids. Yeah. Oh, okay.
So if you're a cosmetologist or a barber, can you have like your hand or a musician?
Oh,
can
that's
you
have a good question.
Yeah, yeah. Now, we don't have any policies for that. But
artists.
I know a bunch
tattoo artists. Yeah. Hands.
I know a bunch of independent brokers who could do stuff.
Now, I would love to be able to insure my son and his hands. Now, I think about that all the time.
Now check this out. Based on what y'all was talking about earlier with the guns and carrying and all of that, they have independent brokers that will insure you, because I have that too from another company. So if I do pop off on somebody, I got an insurance situation that's going to allow me to have my attorneys there to make sure I'm good. Mm. They sent out information to teach me how I need to roll. If somebody come in my house, I can blast off. But if they on the porch or if they outside, I can't blast off. So you got insurance companies that are there to help you with that, too.
I don't know if you're going to shoot.
Before
we leave,
are you familiar with the story of Lords of London when the slaves... Yeah. I have heard now. You can correct me if I'm wrong. One of the main ways that the white boys finance bringing slaves over here from Africa... They got insurance policies from Lords of London.
Lords of London, yep.
And the insurance policy would say basically if 20% or 30%, some percentage of slaves don't make it, you will receive the money for
that. That makes sense.
So when they arrived at the shores.
Oh, they was busting them off.
And they could see the land, and more than that had survived, 90% had survived. And the insurance policy was saying that only 80% were going to survive. They threw niggas overboard.
Throw them overboard.
That's wild.
And then came on in and collected the policy. And that's how they financed the trip.
Financed trips and made money.
But as black people, we not even thinking about how to move with life insurance because it can be a financial vehicle.
That's what I'm getting
You
at.
Dig?
That's what I'm getting at.
It can be a financial vehicle, and that's how we need to start looking at it.
That's what I'm getting at. Ladies and gentlemen, go ahead.
And if you wrapping this up, I just want to say there's two type of illiteracies for my brother Earthquake, and I believe it.
Yeah.
There's one where you're reading out loud, and you're reading to yourself.
Yeah.
Right.
So maybe he can't read out loud.
But he can.
I know I could.
He's in the military.
He can.
You don't have to read out loud in the military.
Earthquake smart. He can.
You don't got to read out loud in the military.
He's smart, man.
He may not be no Darwin, or he may not be no scholar. Neither am I.
Right.
You know.
Right.
I mean, I ain't read, but I ain't reading no 3,000 books a year. That night.
serious question.
But you can read out loud though. Some people can't read out loud.
Serious question.
And if he can't. So what?
Well, I'm just saying cat should have qualified that.
I can count.
Don't know.
So even if I can't read out, do what you do.
Yeah. Mm. Serious question.
But I'm a big read. I'm a big Earthquake fan, by the way.
Serious question someone asked.
That's my man.
What right. do you do for special need kids for insurance? Somebody asked that question.
Well, your daddy asked me that, Bo.
there's insurance for that.
Okay.
But again, it falls under the underwriting.
Your helmet, Mr. P.
It falls sure under the underwriting. Right. You know, it's based on the type of situation and all of that. But underwriting would determine that.
Hey, man, you did a good job, man. Thank you.
A hell of a job.
We're going to have you back, man.
Well, that way we can talk about health and something else.
We're going to have you back and talk about something else.
DC, I tell you, it's an honor, man. Right. You are a national treasure, man. That's real, man. The likes on this thing should be bing, bing, bing,
you don't even say that kind of shit about people. They got about 6 months to live.
Yeah.
So you saying I should insure it?
If it's available.
I got you. Yeah.
Oh, and sure, DC? Yeah. Oh, I thought you were talking about the kid. Oh,
can I say one more thing real
quick? Yeah, go ahead, man.
This ain't the topic. I tried to keep it to life insurance, but the liability piece, I just want to touch on that real quick.
Yeah.
There's something called an umbrella policy. Because you asked if somebody like, it's something you said, but let's say they come to your house and they at your barbecue, all of a sudden they want to sue you.
Yeah. And then fall on the grill or something.
All of that.
Let me show you a picture.
You need that umbrella policy. But the only problem with check this out. The only problem with the umbrella policy, though, is that means you got to take your auto insurance to $250,000 instead of $25,000. Damage property and property damage. You got to take it up to another level. But if you take it up to that level, because this is how we started talking.
Mm-hmm.
You take it up to that level, then you can get an umbrella policy, and the umbrella policies don't really cost that much. But you got to step up to $250,000.
That's how we started the conversation.
Right,
which breaks down to what a month? Because I got to see how much a month.
You go to JoeMcKnightSF.com. JoeMcKnightSF.com. You can get a quote. You dig?
That was my next point. Give us information about where to contact.
And the beauty about the type of website I have is you can get all the quotes and everything you want right there. But I got a great staff.
And they're going to ask all the questions.
678-666. Ooh. 4370.
678-666. 4370. Can we put that on the screen, Will?
All right.
678.
Woo part two.
666.
Don't put the woo part.
4370.
Well, Rev would tell you, if you're worried about 666, that means you... if you worried about that, then that means you, what they call it?
6969.
No, the other thing where you... Oh, you...
worship the devil.
No, that six, means six, you... 666. That means you...
worship the
superstitious.
Devil.
Superstitious. There's the word.
Superstitious.
Yeah.
They used to have medicine, 666. My dad used to give us this shit, fix anything.
Yeah, fix anything.
678. Go ahead, D.
678. 666.
Ooh.
4370.
4370. Or just go to JoeMcKnightSF.com and you can get it. Everything right there.
Joe, thank you, man. I appreciate it.
Oh, man, black people, man, with this life insurance, it's a disgrace with a G.
Why you look at me when he did
no,
that?
No, I did this. He
black.
Did everybody catch that?
Because you was in my pocket. Get your hands out my pocket.
He was that way when he looked at me when he said it.
You've been listening to This Race. I'm DC Curry.
I'm Bo P.
I'm Sister JJ.
And I'm just visiting Ted Carpenter.
Our special guest, Joe McKnight. Cookie Hull is in the building. Carla is in the building. Angelo Dundee. Will, I'm glad I ain't Smith. Reverend Dr. Brian Harper. Bullhead, the Muslim. Weight Balls. We'll holler.
Hey, man, Smash, thanks for the info.
I go to the place where danger awaits me, Carla. And it's bound to forsake.